Hey everyone, Raptor Rising here. Welcome to Weasels Over Syria. And it is going to be a great campaign. We're going to get our aircraft started up. Contact tower. Let's get this thing rolling.
Hotel 4 ground, Sword 2-1 requesting engine start.
Sword 2-1, you are cleared to start engine.
You heard the man.
Engine online.
All right, push 7 on comm 2.
Sword flight, sword leap, radio check. Sword 1-2.
Sword 2-1 is up.
Sword 2-2 is up.
Altitude.
Lean and Charlie, sword flight, now get airborne. I'll see you all at waypoint 1. Remember to make sure you talk to H4 tower departure as required. Lead out.
Caution. Bingo. Data. IFF.
Foreground, Sword 2-1 requesting taxi.
Sword 2-1, you are cleared for taxi.
Sword 2-1.
Alright, taxi clearance. Time to go. Brake check. And we got nose wheel steering. Looking good. Kind of cool thing about H4 is you just basically slop onto the runways from the hangar. You don't have to do any crazy taxiway maneuvering, just straight on. One thing I really like so far is the detailed ATC procedures. You have, you know, your tower and departures and arrival frequencies and everything like that. Ground Pounder's done a really good job at simulating that.
Hotel 4 Tower, Sword 2-1 requesting takeoff.
Sword 2-1, you are cleared for takeoff on runway 28. Wind 300 over 4 knots, altimeter 2984.
Sort 2-1.
That's clearance. And rolling.
Sort 2-1, rolling. Sword 2-1, wheels up.
A little bumpy. So I need to stay below 4,000 per departure rules. And I'm going to maintain 280 whilst doing that. This is a familiarization flight of the AO, particularly the H4 area of operations. And we're going to do a simulated attack on a Fansong. And we'll see how that goes. We're going to practice some weasel tactics. Should be interesting. All right, we're going to go COM 2, 3, and contact. Departure.
Hotel 4, departure, sort 2-1, departing from runway 28.
Sort 2-1, turn heading 250, climb flight level 200.
250, flight level 200, sort 2-1. Sword 1-1, Sword 2-1 approaching RV point.
Copy 2-1. Sword flight form up. We're pushing for waypoint 2, Angels 2-5. Forrest, I want your element in 1 mile trail.
Sword 2-1.
By the EVGA Sentinel. Once clear of H4CA, we must declare ourselves on mission to Sentinel. Sword 2-1, I want you to check our flight in now.
Sword 2-1. Sentinel, Sword 2-1, checking in flight of 4 F-16s on mission number 0423, inbound on the SWRC.
Sword 2-1, you are clear to proceed. You advise clear and patrol to airborne north of your position. Majesty's monitoring, we will update you as needed.
Copy all, Sentinel. Sword 2-1 out.
And that's Popeye right there. I need to lag behind him 1 mile. I may have aggressively lead turned him or something. Actually, no, I'm good. Okay, so there's Popeye up ahead. We are 1 mile trail. We'll continue ascending to 25,000 feet.
Off to our left is Syria. The border is visible at our 10 o'clock, clearly marked by the berm that runs parallel to the road running northeast. The long, thin lake at 11 o'clock lies within the Jordanian side of the border, so it's a useful landmark to reference.
Okay.
The Kurds are deployed quite heavily in this area. Not surprising considering what's going on down in Syria. They're also maintaining a cap of F-16s around the clock.
So there's the lake he's referring to, that road. There's a berm just beyond it. That is the border to Syria from Jordan. Alright, so I mentioned weasel tactics, and basically what we're going to do is we're going to bait this SA-2. Lead flight is going to be the bait. They are going to maintain high altitude, stave off the missile attacks. We're going to break north, descend low altitude, and make a pass on the radar, and hopefully knock it out. That's kind of a high-level overview of what we're doing. We've got to come in at a very specific course to avoid other threats that are at the base.
3 o'clock is a large lake. This lake is around 6 miles north of H4, and it's another useful reference point to help orient yourself to home. As we return to H4, we'll use two initial points to approach the base. Approach Alpha is a wind farm near a small lake. You might have seen it off to our right as we made the low-level departure from runway 28. Approach Bravo might just be visible in the distance beyond the lake. It's a shale oil facility, usually easy enough to ID from all the smoke it's kicking out. It's the smoke to the left as we look at it. The smoke to the right is from a factory complex in Ruage. Other than scattered settlements and industry, that's about all there is to see out here.
Sure is remote. What an assignment. Miles and miles of flat desert.
We'll be dying to get to Syria just to see some scenery. Never mind the action.
Well, there'll be plenty of that to go around before long, I'm sure. Syrian SAMs keep coming up when the JSTF is around the no-fly zone. We'll be needed up north before long, I'm sure.
Huh, no doubt.
So the Swartz looks like quite the playground. Miles and miles of empty space to train in. It'll be like being back in Nevada.
Well, I don't think the flying will be quite that good, but it's always good to get the chance to drop live ordnance.
Doubt it's quite as well set up as the NTTR.
Not a chance. The emitters and targets aren't quite as realistic as we're used to. We'll have to make do with old pickups and containers today, but they'll do the job.
And we've still got an instrument in range, at least.
Kinda cool how the old H3 complex has been repurposed.
Yeah, the place has quite the history of being bombed. The H3 complex, as it became, was built back in the 70s. It consisted of the main base plus two dispersal fields and highway landing strips. The Iranians attacked it during their war with Iraq. Then we attacked it again in 91. It was a chemical weapons storage site back then. We hit it again during Southern Watch before an OIF finally capturing it. Since then, it's been abandoned and left to the desert.
Yep, and now it's our turn. Let's see if we can't add a few more craters to the landscape, huh?
I like the enthusiasm. Sure we will.
All right, so I'm going to need to come in waypoint 4, which is our target, at a course of 145 to avoid AAA. So I'm going to go ahead and set that now. So when I brake, I don't have to worry about it. So we are closing in on the target fairly rapidly now.
Okay, flight, we're approaching the border into Iraq. Push uniform to Games Master.
1-2, set.
2-2, set.
2-1, set.
Games Master Sword 1-1, flight of 4 F-16s checking in as fragged on approach to Swartz.
Copy, Sword 1, range is clear and targets are set. You are clear for unrestricted flight within the AO. Weapons released within the range has been authorized. Monitor this frequency at all times. Games Master will call kills on blue units if you deem evasive measures to be inadequate.
Copy all, Games Master. Sword is proceeding. Sword 2, go combat spread 1 mile left.
Sword 2-1.
Okay, flight, remember what we briefed. Once engaged by the SA-2, Sword 1 will break south and stay high on the edge of the threat ring. Sword 2 will break north and dive for the deck. Watch your spacing and keep track of your wingman. Flight, fence in.
Okay, fencing in. Looks like we're good. Course line set. Good. Lights off. Fuel's looking good. There's our target right there.
Sword 1-1 fenced. White, roll call.
Sword 1-2.
Sword 2-1.
Sword 2-2.
Approaching Mez, music on.
Music on.
Music on.
Sword 1 breaking south. Sword 2 break north, commence attack.
Alright, well, we're going to go ahead and commence. I don't know why my music's not coming on. It is on now.
Sword 1 defending SA-2.
Strange. Okay, not going to worry about that. We're going to break north, and we're going to go ahead and descend. quickly. Monitor that course line and we'll come back in. Make our run.
Missile in the air, Sword 1 defending SA 2.
Yeah, simulated smoke. It's pretty cool.
Altitude. Pull up.
Yeah, we're low altitude. We're gonna do a pop-up attack. Just fine-tuning my course. Locked. Offset just a smidge. Correct that. And that is just about perfect. About 6 miles now. We are going to drop both CBUs in one pass. Hopefully that does something. These are notoriously unreliable in my opinion. But we'll see. These are loft Q. And pull up, pull up, pull up, pull up, pull up, pull up. And they're gone.
Missile launch, Sword 1 defending SA 2.
Pull up. Pull up. Pull up.
Sword 2 1 is in.
Altitude.
Sword 2 1 off target.
Nice.
Sex. Stance song is history.
Yeah, that was freaking awesome.
Outstanding.
Working that loft cue perfectly. Alright, so we'll keep low level.
Music off.
Out of the AO. Or our target area anyway. And then we'll form back up. Go ahead and disarm that laser. I was holding my breath while those CBUs were coming in, but they ended up hitting perfectly. We're looking really good on gas too. Excellent.
Sword 2-2, spike, SA-3.
Sword 2-2, break left. 1 breaking right. Music on. 0 papa.
Music on.
Sword 1, Sword 2. SA-3 online in the vicinity of the H-3 Southwest site.
Copy 2. You have the fuel to make a run at it?
I can make a gun run, but... why not?
2-1 is cannon only, but I'm good to go.
Okay, Sword Flight, let's get back to work. We're going to locate and kill the SA-3 around the H-3 Southwest site. Stand by for base coordinates. North, 32, 44, decimal 656. East, 0.0393636.217. 2671 feet. We're going to work this as a four-ship and overwhelm it from four directions. File attack from the west. Sword 1-2, arc south. Sword 2-1, arc east. And 2-2, north. SA-3 MES is 10 miles, so keep out of range as you maneuver into position. We'll attack in elements. While one element is attacking, the other will try and hold the radar's attention. Call attacking if you go hot on the target, defending if you break away. Gamesmaster will call any kills against it.
Sword 1-2.
Sword 2-1.
Okay, so I need to get east of this.
Sword 2-2, ready.
So I want to come from like that direction. So I'm going to cross it this way and then come back. It's already outside of 20 miles to my left, which is the north. I'm going to go proceed east a bit, and then I'll use this course knob to intercept an easterly attack run. Yeah, I like this.
Sort 2-1 in position.
Sword 1 attacking SA-3, H-3 south.
So it's going to orbit while lead is attacking the SAM site. Bingo is 3,900, so I need to respect that. In fact, I should probably set that up. There we go. Just to keep track of it.
Sword 1-1, spike.
Sword 1-2, missile launch. SA-3, H-3, south.
Sword 1, defending SA-3. Sword 2, get a mark point on the launch position.
Copy. Sword 2, attacking SA-3, H-3, south.
Aha! That's a low blow.
Galley launch site, horseshoe-shaped revetment, north corner of the base.
Okay, we're gonna go in low level and we're gonna knock this sucker out.
Altitude.
The mark point created. We'll go guns mode. Here we go. Gotta focus on getting there now.
Spike, SA-3. SAM launch, SA-3, H-3 south.
Sort 2 defending.
Sword 1 attacking SA-3, H-3 south. Jump the gun. Not about the kill, but the tactics that get us to kill. Reset east and let's go again.
Ah, come on, man. Got me. Got me getting greedy. Okay, fair enough.
Missile launch, SA-3, H-3 south. Sword 1-2,
enemy on launch site, engaging.
Altitude.
It's still up about 50 meters northeast of the smoke. Sword 2, press.
Sword 2 attacking SA-3, H-3 south.
You gonna make me do this again?
Good work, Sword Flight.
Alright, nice.
Roll call.
Sword 1-2.
Sword 2-1.
Sword Flight, push rally.
I guess my gun kills counted, even though I was naughty and decided to sneak in anyway. I feel like, in reality, flying the way I was, at the altitude I was, that SA-3 would not have hit me, so I didn't feel like I needed to egress, but to Popeye's point, it's not about the kill, but the tactics that get us the kill, so I am humbled.
At rally.
Sword Flight, vent south. Push waypoint 6, Angel 2-5.
Activity pod.
Sword 2-1, we're clearing the sword seat. Check us back in with Sentinel.
Sword 2-1. Sentinel, Sword Flight is egressing Swartzy and inbound on H-4, Angels 2-5.
Sword Flight, good for speed, Angels 2-5.
I asked Games Master to throw a surprise at us on the way out. They sure came through. Well, hopefully that blew away some of the cobwebs. Attacking SAMs is definitely a skill that degrades if you don't use it. Good work with the SA-2. We exploited its lack of ability to track low-flying targets. An effective strategy for sure, but we still have to be mindful of low-level threats. Here we saw how loitering just on the edge of the engagement range baited the operators into firing, a useful distraction tactic, and also helpful in forcing the SAM site to reveal its exact position. The SA-3 is a lot more dangerous than the guideline. Although more limited in range, its missiles are much more of a threat than with the SA-2. It lacks the low-level vulnerability of the SA-2, but today we switched up tactics and went with a saturation attack from multiple attack axes. Remember that even though the Syrians had lots of older SAMs like we've seen today, they've still got plenty of more modern systems as well. Make sure you understand the vulnerabilities of all systems and attack where they're weakest.
What's the EW situation up north? Are we expecting to see some Growler support or something? Sure would make the job easier when we come up against the double-digit systems.
When we need it, we'll have it. I'm assured of this.
Roger that. So, boss. When are we going to be in the action for real?
Soon enough, Rotor, soon enough. With the operation kicking off against the SIA and the demand for support around the no-fly zones, I can't see us having to wait too long.
Let's hope not. I can't face weeks of sitting around this desert waiting for something to do. Me neither, man. What I'd give for a trip to Nellis right now. Get me some of that good Vegas life.
What, and miss the wife out here?
Well, I wouldn't want to miss out on the flying, but I could pass on life at H4.
Well, take it from me, after seeing action at both OIF and OPF, you'll never have flying quite like you do on an operation like this.
You saw a lot of action in Persian Freedom, didn't you, Popeye?
That's right. Weasels were right in the middle of the opening phase of OPF. Part of the wave that kicked the door open over mainland Iran at the start.
Must have been pretty hairy. The Iranians had some impressive equipment.
Well, at the start it was. Had a few S-300s to take out early on, but we had a solid plan, plenty of EW support, and, well, we're just better at this than anyone else. I guarantee you're better trained at killing SAMs than the SAM operators are at killing you.
A lot more of them than us, though.
Okay, we're inbound on H4. I've done this approach more than the rest of you, so Sword 2-1, I want you to take the lead and bring us on in. First step is to declare to H4 approach that we're inbound. Typically, do this around 50 miles out and before you reach the 30-mile boundary of H4 control airspace. Do it now. I'll follow you in.
Okay, we're going to go COM 2, Channel 4. And contact via the F-10 menu.
Hotel 4 approach, Sword 2-1 inbound.
Sword 2-1, proceed to Hotel 4 airspace. Check in at flight level 160. Push to RAPCON arrival at 30 mile mark.
Flight level 160, Sword 2-1.
Okay, Sword 2-1, proceed to H-4 airspace. You want to beat Angels 16. 30 miles out from H4. TAC end for H4 is 125 X-ray.
All right, we're going to go ahead and start descending to 16,000 feet.
Sword 2-1, you're entering H4 airspace now. Push to H4 arrival and declare your flight.
Hotel 4 arrival, Sword 2-1 entering Hotel 4 airspace.
Sword 2-1, cleared for approach Bravo. Adjust altitude to flight level 160.
Approach Bravo, flight level 160, Sword 2-1.
Okay, Sword 2-1, we're cleared in on approach Bravo at Angels 1-6. Bravo is the oil facility that's smoking in the distance. You'll also find it listed as waypoint 8 in your flight plan. Bravo is our safe approach to pattern airspace, so make sure you don't deviate. We have traffic ahead.
Sword 2-1, clear to enter pattern. Flight level 080.
Flight level 080, Sword 2-1.
2-1, take us down to Angels 8 and feed us into the pattern. Make sure you avoid overflying Ruwaish below 7,500 feet MSL. The Jordanians have a noise restriction in place over the town. Hold in the pattern until we're cleared to push to the tower.
Alright, so this is our pattern for H4. And we're at 8,000 feet right now. We're making pretty big wide circles, but that's fine.
4-2-1, exit pattern and push the tower.
Oh, okay, cool. I'm no longer in the pattern.
Sort 2-1.
But that's the pattern, so 2.5 mile spread.
Okay, sir, 2-1, switch to tower freak and get us cleared to land.
2 and 2. 2, 2, 2. And...
Hotel 4 tower, Sword 2-1, requesting landing.
Sword 2-1, cleared for landing runway 10, wind 300 for 4 knots.
Sword 2-1, go ahead and land. We'll follow you down once you clear the runway. Good flying, good day, everyone. See you in debrief.
Okay. Off to the ground we go. Yeah, it's a little bumpy down here. Ay, ay, ay. Wind's rough. And the runway is short.
Four, 2-1, clear runway and proceed to spot 8.
Spot 8. Middle hangar. Nice, that's a really cool graphic. Rock on. So that's mission one of Weasels over Syria. This is going to be an intense campaign. I'm really liking the attention to detail and the weasel tactics. The dialogue is really good. So far, it seems like a solid campaign. So let me know what you guys think of it and what you thought of the gameplay video in the comments below. We'll shut down the jet. And we'll catch you guys in the next video. This has been Raptor Rising. Raptor out.